Okay.
All right, so should I go?
Yeah, you're good.
Are we live?
You never ask that.
Oh, well, you didn't say anything. Okay, so
presumably
you should
introduce
yourself.
Yeah, I'm Cassio, and this is Mirror's Edge Catalyst. And it's basically a reboot of the original Mirror's Edge. So they take Faith, the main character, and her role as a parkour messenger girl, and it gets transplanted into this futuristic sci-fi world. That's about it. It's pretty much still a parkour game. Still lots of free running. Just now it's in sci-fi and has an open world.
Yeah, and I'm Hecky, and I talk.
Yeah.
That's pretty much all I do.
Hecky talks a lot.
That's
when
a lie.
He can be prompted.
Okay. So should we explain the plot as you play the game? Or?
I guess we can try. There's not a lot of plot to explain.
That's my delay.
So this is a release, the first level. Faith has been released from jail, and so now we have to run away from the police. Because we don't want to go rejoin society.
So yeah.
This is the first... This is the first, like, skip.
I can't really see where you are right now.
I'm jumping into, like, a check.
Oh, okay.
A cutscene figure.
So usually you would have to take the stairs, and it introduces the whole safe landing mechanics.
Now, normally, I would try to wall run kick that guy, but I messed up. And if you wall run kick him, you skip that annoying animation.
And seems this is like 5 seconds?
About, yeah. And this is the first major skip that I'm coming up on, the warehouse skip, also known as the trash bag skip. You climb some objects you are not supposed to climb, and it's kind of awkward, but that went off without a hitch, so that's nice.
Nice.
And that
saves warehouse.
Saves like 15-20 seconds. It's pretty nice. And this is the first wall boost, so wall boosting is like the probably the biggest movement thing in this game. Basically, when you're wall running, you're faster, and if you jump off of walls, like as soon as you touch them, you'll go even faster. So we jump off of walls a lot to go faster.
A lot of people have like different wall boosting capabilities, I'd like to say. Because it's like, the further away from the wall you do it, the more speed you get, I think. I might be wrong on that. I'm not too well knowledged on this game, actually.
Yeah, that's about right. So, we're through the warehouse now.
Have you done a B-hop yet?
I have not. Bunny hops are the second, like, component of wall boosting as a movement thing, and I died. But you basically, when you jump off of a wall, Faith doesn't quite get on the ground as soon as she touches it, and so you actually can do another wall run jump as soon as you touch the ground if you jump, like, immediately. And this maintains the speed of the wall run jump, so you can keep that speed almost indefinitely.
Has, like, a 3-frame window.
Yeah, it's pretty tough. And I just skipped an animation that would play when I landed on that ladder by jumping onto that air conditioning unit. Otherwise it would be like 2 or 3 seconds of time wasted.
So if you can't tell already, Icarus is like the game douchebag. And he doesn't like you at all.
We're gonna be seeing a lot of Icarus. And he's mostly going to be getting caught and making mistakes.
So basically, this game didn't really have like a pre-story as to why you start in prison. unless you read the comics. And basically, you help someone steal some medicine, and then you go to jail for it, or something.
We're coming up on a skip that I did not have in my world record run. But first, we're going to do a float glitch, which lets you, or, well, glide glitch. It lets you drift at basically crawling speed, but you don't have, like, you don't fall. So it's useful for letting you get, like, out of bounds and stuff. You do it by just, like, walking off a ledge in the animation of Faith, like, starting to crouch. And then, this is the end of the tutorial, so I'm going to back into this door, and that's going to trigger a prompt at the end of the tutorial, and if I hit yes on it, then the tutorial ends without me going through the tutorial. And that lets me just skip about a minute of dumb stuff. And I tried to skip the slow-mo in that window by looking away from the center, but I guess I didn't look far enough.
So that door thing works, because Faith has a big booty and it clips through the door.
Yeah, so we call it the butt skip.
The end of the tutorial. How much does that save? Like, a minute? I think it's like a minute.
Ugh, guards being a pain.
So now there's just more kind of like running and platforming.
This game, one thing that I do not like is that it emphasized the combat, and there's a lot of fighting in this game, and a lot of it is mandatory. So you'll see some of that. We've optimized the combat pretty well, but it's one of the places where you can lose time without really having control over it.
Yeah. Release is pretty reset heavy.
Yeah, it's kind of like prologue in the original game. Lots and lots of optimizations, yeah. Except this time it's 7 minutes long.
Good. So getting onto this pole and walking backwards will make you grab the one above. Oh wait, no, I have a big delay, never mind.
Don't mind it. I guess you can probably talk like...
I'll try and talk ahead of time.
Or you can talk mechanical details or story or whatever. I can try to explain stuff as I do it. And I just skipped some tutorial prompts while jumping. And one other thing, those landing pads that, you know, like cushion your fall, you can... Normally they have a very long animation when you land on them, but you can cut it down by about half by mashing the crouch button as you approach them. And we don't know why that happens, but it does.
Yeah, I have no idea why that would happen. There's no logical sense to it.
And we are about done with release. Now, there's one big consequence of doing the butt skip. The tutorial gives you heavy attack, which you use to knock people around. And since we skipped the tutorial, we don't have heavy attack. And we need heavy attack for the next mission. So we're gonna need to do some messing with the game a bit.
Don't you next... buy heavy attack here instead of the map?
Yeah, next we are going to be taught how to buy the map that we use to find stuff. But the map is already given to us, and so we're actually just going to buy heavy attack, but it's gonna put us behind in terms of skill points. So that changes the route from what we did before we did the butt skip.
Cutscenes in this game are loading, so if you see one of these and skipping is stuck in the bottom right, it means the game is loading. And now you get your clothes that someone has been keeping for like 2 years, because that's not creepy.
We're heading to see Birdman, who is a surprisingly irrelevant character to the plot, but...
Yeah, they hyped him up a lot in the trailer.
Oh, collision boost. You're gonna like that, Hucky. But, he is the beginning runner, the very first runner, but we don't see much of him, because he's not very important to the plot.
Should I explain how collision boosts work?
Yeah, you know them better than I do, so go ahead.
Sure. So basically, if you run over something that sticks out of a wall with collision, the game speeds you up dramatically to try and make the transition over that object seem like kind of seamless. But you can actually jump in the middle of the transition and it will conserve all the speed and shoot you off the wall. And I think that's the fastest method of movement in the game. But it's also kind of hard because it has a couple frames window.
Now, one thing I didn't get to explain, exactly, was it explaining collision boost? I went up like a slide on the way to Birdman's, and normally you can't run up those, you'll just slide down them, but if you pause a lot, which is basically pause buffering, you reset your position, and so you can keep climbing up and up, and it's faster than going through the building.
Wall kick. Goddamn. So now there's just like more running through this dash.
Yeah, dashes are like little time trials scattered throughout the world. Some people are very, very good at them.
Yeah.
I am okay.
Dashes are kind of, they're pretty cool, but they're also kind of hard.
Yeah, lots of collision boosts in competitive dashes.
Yeah. So, what skill did we buy now?
Sorry?
What skill did we buy after Birdman?
We actually don't buy a skill at that point because there's nothing really to buy. The only thing to buy is beat map.
Oh. Okay.
You have to buy the map to unlock all the other skills, and so.
Oh, yeah.
I don't need the map. I'm just gonna wait on that point. Now, this is a weird thing. There's a cutscene over here, and I'm gonna skip it by, like, falling in a weird way. But it makes me teleport in a very strange way. This is a tutorial for dodging, and they don't show you the tutorial, but you're supposed to dodge in front of that guy when he tries to attack you. But since I skipped the cutscene and the triggers, he just sort of stands there, and I have to dodge around him and then beat him up. Yet. Also, there's a character named Dogen in this game.
We don't know why the guard's unresponsive, but he just sort of stands there. So now we follow the Hyrule Avenue thing.
Yeah, we're following the path of another dash right now, even though we're not actually doing the dash. Now we're beating up some guards, and I'm almost always going to be using an attack from higher ground on enemies, because that does basically tons of damage. Come on, get over here. Thank you very much.
Okay, I got the last one.
Good, but we have a problem. Faith, no head. What's happening?
K-Sec is happening.
Could you explain how the fighting works? Like, which is fastest? Why you keep going at all these stuff?
It's pretty simple. You have a heavy attack that staggers people, and a light attack that gives you, like, momentum shield. And you don't really need momentum shield, because every time you kill an enemy, you get a giant chunk of it. So, we mostly just focus on using heavy attack to keep enemies, like, stunned and hitting them from above. There's not a lot of complexity to it. Now, there was a glitch that happened during my practice runs around this point, and I'm gonna see if it happens. But if it does, it should be quite entertaining.
Where?
There's a dead drop at the marker on your map.
Oops. Sorry.
Doesn't appear it happened. That sucks. Oh well. The glitch in question made Faith's body disappear for quite a while. I'm still not sure what caused it, but it was interesting. Now, this mission is almost a dash in itself. It's called Be Like Water, and it's basically just like running around, and they teach you how to do light attacks. That was another cool boost.
Be Like Water is the best mission by far. It's my favorite.
I forgot to mention, at some points, after most of these missions, I would be in an any percent run. I would normally be loading the release mission and then aborting it, because that would teleport me to the lair. But that's only faster in game time. It's not faster in real time. So for entertainment purposes and for speed, I'm skipping a lot of those.
There. I hope it's worth all the trouble.
It's just better than watching load screens.
Yeah, there's already enough load screens in this game. That's one of the weaknesses of this game. There's load screens are like 30 seconds long each.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. So, those little yellow things just floating around are called gridlings. They don't really do anything. You just sort of get them. It's Dice's attempt at, like, overworld collectibles.
There's a lot
of give you a tiny amount of XP.
We've been sort of, like, planning 100% runs for ages, and we've never done them because they're so long.
Yeah.
Now we're coming up on the first, like, real mission. Well, aside from release, but the first mission where you have, like, skills and stuff. This should be interesting. It's called Back in the Game. And here's Icarus and Noah, two main characters who don't really do much.
No, they just sort of hang around and die.
We won't tell you which one dies, though.
Oh yeah, my bad. I'm sorry. I forgot people came here for the story, and I ruined it. So, what else? There's like something big that we didn't talk about, and I'm not sure what it is.
What's the first letter it starts with?
I don't know, I can't... It feels like we missed something, but maybe we didn't.
We got wall boost, bunny hops, collision boosts, glide glitch. Oh, the quick turn glitch?
Yeah, but you don't have quick turn yet, so.
Yeah, I guess, once we get quick turn.
It's kind of pointless explaining it if you don't have it.
Alright, now this is kind of a tricky area, because without quick turn, this area is kind of hard. But we'll see how it goes. First, we have to do a wall run on a thing you're generally not supposed to wall run on. But it works, so that was good.
So usually at this point, you would have quick turn and there would be lots of other strats, but you skip quick turn because of the float glitch in the first mission.
Yeah, the butt skip. So, I did a bunch of weird glitches there that kind of make this faster. I think the one I wanted to mention was the ledge board, where you use climbing up onto a ledge to sort of boost yourself really high up. And that's what we used to get really high up. Sorry, what were you saying, Hecky?
I was just going to explain ledge boarding.
Oh yeah. That's what it is. It's a super jump, sort of.
Yeah, basically. Oh man, I wish I didn't have like a huge delay so I could actually talk about what's happening.
That's alright. You can still contribute for valuable commentary. This is, I think, the last annoying new skip.
I'm finishing this.
And I failed it. I'll give it one more try. You have to get a very high up wall run to get to this ledge.
Yeah, this trick is pretty dumb. It was better when you didn't use it.
Alright, I got it. Now you can get some crazy bunny hops here, but I am not good at bunny hopping. Well, that was alright. Oops. Yeah, my one of my big goals here is to not die, because there are load screens.
What's the data we're grabbing again?
For those, and they're pretty long, like every load screen.
Yeah, everything has a load screen.
Now, you might notice I'm sort of like zipping forward to press these, or to break down these vents. And that's a neat little trick that you can just get by mashing the use button when you're approaching them. It's not really, I don't know if it really counts as a glitch, but it's cool.
See if I can get a stream without delay.
That would be very handy.
This area is different.
So, what else is happening now? Are we just running at this point?
We're now in the cutscene. For back in the game, where you discover a body. It's interesting.
Okay.
So now we have to get out of this building that we have been running through, and we meet the enemy who has a gun, and they are very, very annoying, because they are basically impossible to avoid, and they might kill you later, so we'll see how that goes. And we avoided another a slow-mo with that blast break earlier by looking away from the center again. So, lots of slow-mo skips. I think there's a slow-mo skip for the zipline, but I don't know how to do it. I've never seen an explanation, just heard about it.
I think you die.
Well, that sounds slow in an RTA run.
Yeah.
I've been telling you for years, we don't do runs against Krugersek. And then what's the first thing you do when you get out?
So, differences between this game and the original. It's, the movement is, really weird. In the original, you have slow movement that builds up to fast, and that's a big dynamic in that game. Whereas in this game, you're pretty much always fast, but it's kind of harder to control, because there's no real slow pace. You're just always fast. So it's got its ups and its downs. You actually have an ability in this game called Shifts, and it literally just brings you to full speed every time you press it. No cooldown and no cost, so it's a double-edged sword.
It's pretty good.
I keep accidentally opening the console. But that was back in the game, and now I've purchased Quick Turn, which is basically the most broken skill in the game, because Quick Turn, it lets you turn around while climbing a wall, and you stick to the wall for a very long time, and can jump off of it from a very wide number of angles, so you can do some really silly things with this, which I will demonstrate in later levels, but it's a very powerful skill. It, prior to doing Quick Turn, having Quick Turn in back in the game, that mission would typically take a minute and a half longer. Anyways, we just learned how to disrupt fans, which is only useful in like two places, but it is what it is.
Yeah, it's just there for show, really.
I mean, it's there so that you can't go past the fans until you reach X point in the storyline, but...
Yeah.
That is an enemy trying to stop me, but there's no reason to stop for him. And his gun.
I guess it's better than just deactivating the fan for no reason. They may as well tie it to something.
Now we are helping out another character named, what's his name?
Nomad,
yeah. And Nomad is like a kid who is not a runner, but hangs out with runners and may as well be a runner.
Nomad is weird. Yeah, there's like Nomad... a lot of tension between Faith and Nomad, but nothing ever happens.
Yeah. Nomad just sort of shows up once in a while and demands help, something or other. He's interesting. Kind of useless. A lot of characters in this game seem to show up and then not do anything.
Yeah, they're just like a build up for like side missions and stuff. And everyone knows that side missions are the best missions.
I managed to avoid another takedown animation by knocking that guy into an object to finish him out.
Does a deathless run exist? I'm not sure.
I don't think anyone has gotten a PB where they haven't died. You definitely could avoid dying for the entire run, although there are some tricks that abuse death to get to checkpoints.
So I guess unintentional deaths you could do?
Yeah, you could definitely get one of those. That was really strange. I've never had that happen before. Oh, that wasn't a ledge. Ugh, I'm so dumb. But, yeah. That was dumb. But this is basically KSEC Alert, and it basically is the cops chasing you. And
yeah,
it's kind of like GTA.
Like, but mandatory open world stuff.
Yeah. So, sorry about that. That was silly of me. This is a very silly RTA optimized run, and I am going some places that I have not been in a while, because we usually do release aborts. Hopefully we can minimize silly deaths.
That sounds awful, Kitsune. That would tilt me pretty hard.
Yeah, there's a lot of running around in this game. It takes up most of the runtime, just running between stuff. It's why we started doing release aborts, because they save so much game time. But in a RTA run, it's really just run everywhere. But at least it makes the most of the parkour. I can't believe I didn't get a disrupt there. I am dying in the silliest ways. If I get restarted to the... If I get restarted, I'm gonna have to do a release abort just to get it over with, because this is ridiculous.
Yeah.
I am so embarrassed.
Don't worry about it, it's fine.
I can't believe the band didn't get this one.
Do you have it on scroll?
Yeah, I have it on scroll.
Did you scroll too fast?
I don't think so, but I guess I must have. Hopefully we'll finish this mission someday soon.
That's really far back.
Yeah, I always send you back to that one. This is the worst mission I could be dying on. My estimate is pretty conservative though, so I should beat it. This is the any percent for game time. You just end the chase by going to a safe house, but since it's really far from where you need to be, you use a release abort to get there. And release aborts are very slow, but at least in RTA, so. I just don't want to die anymore.
The fan killed him?
Yeah, that fan, the fans can't be disrupted from just anywhere. They have, like, hidden, like, points where you have to stand to disrupt them, and that one is really, really small.
And you can't do them while jumping either, or vaulting or anything.
Yeah, that one just sucks, so it killed me.
It's pretty bad for...
But yeah, that's a really support. Gets you to the lair every time you do one, so it's pretty fast sometimes. Just not when you time the loading screens. So now we're going to a different district in the city, and we're going to meet a very eccentric character named Plastic. I don't think we'll actually see her because the cutscene will end before we get to, but she is like
Plastic
a techie.
Is my...
Yeah, she's a love it or hate it character. She's very silly and pop culture-y and a geek.
She's very awkward.
But well, she generally like replaces Noah as your voice in your microphone or in your headphones.
More puns? I could do that.
Oh yeah, pun away.
All right. When some pun opportunities come, I'll do them.
So climbing this ladder is really slow, and so we have the fast climbing upgrade. So you do a bunch of wall climb quick turns to get up there faster, about 2 seconds faster.
I like this room with all the purple and pink.
This district in general is really pretty. This game has a lot of good views, so it depends on whether you think it justifies the loading screens.
Are you playing on low?
Yeah, I'm playing on the lowest setting. Still looks pretty good.
Yeah. I don't understand the, never mind. I'm way far behind.
Still bring it up.
I was gonna talk about the wall on the right side that kind of like opens.
I think that's like a billboard. I mean, we're on the rooftops, so people aren't supposed to be here, generally.
Yeah, but like... Still.
This is Plastic's lair, and she's gonna have a turret that's gonna try to shoot us, but it won't shoot us. Probably.
Probably. It's a big RNG point.
Yeah, if it shoots you, you have to go all the way back to release again.
It doesn't actually shoot you. It's not possible.
Now, the next mission is Savant Extraordinaire, the fifth mission. And it's weird because it's supposed to be this big interior mission with lots of, well, fighting and platforming. But we've discovered that there's a checkpoint at the end that you can just go to, and it gives you like the end of the mission, so you can just go straight to the end and finish it in like a minute. And we have two ways of doing it. One is really hard, and the other is using the glide glitch. So I'm gonna go for the glide glitch because I want to get more mileage out of that. But there is another method that involves getting out of bounds and then doing a weird trick where you wall run and then turn around a corner and climb up a wall around that corner. And it's very hard because it's very short amount of time, and you have to turn the perfect angle in that short amount of time. So it's kind of famous. I might have chanced it if I hadn't died twice earlier, but I gotta be conservative here.
Did you? Oh, you didn't clip the elevator, did you?
No, you only clipped the elevator for the corner wall climb. This is the caveat for the glide glitch. It's kind of finicky to set up.
Yeah.
But still, this is definitely the safer method. Although this method, if you get it, compared to first try, this is about 15 seconds slower, I think.
Yep. I'm asking. I think so.
And so, instead of going to the top of this building and climbing all the way down, we just come to this checkpoint at the bottom of the building and hit it, and you can just finish a level. And fun fact, if you go further up these stairs, you get stuck in a permanent death loop and have to kill your save and start fresh. So that's fun to discover. And that's that mission done.
Yep, so override trigger on the staircase, which automatically completes all the other ones.
There are very few checkpoints like that in this game. There was a lot of work put into keeping people from doing that kind of skip in the development of this game, but they missed that one, I guess.
Yep. Is this where we do the first grid node?
Yep, grid node run. This will unlock fast travel, which is better than doing release aborts, because it takes like 15 seconds instead of 20 seconds, but instead of like 45, which is nice. But this is the first level where quick turn kind of gets abused. And one weird thing about this game is that you can wall climb quick turn into wall runs, which seems impossible by the laws of physics, but is totally possible in this game. And I think that was the first use of the quick turn glitch. Basically, you can turn around wall quick turn and basically jump back at the wall you were just climbing. And that lets you get really, really high up where you shouldn't normally be able to. And so that big puzzle room is done super fast because quick turn is so broken.
Yeah, they didn't really test quick turn.
We use a lot of quick turn glitches because it's just so broken.
Yeah. So I don't actually play this game, I don't run this game, I just play it sometimes.
To be fair, you have a new game plus run, and a pretty good one.
I guess.
New game plus is the other mode where we just do the missions.
Stuff like that. That's what I do.
You find collision boosts.
Yeah. That's all me.
Like, you found basically every collision boost that we know about.
Pretty much. A couple of them weren't found by me. But most of those are for dashes. I don't think you do many collision boosts in the actual Any% run, which is a shame.
Yeah. I've been wanting to see skips using bunny hops from collision boosts for a while, but they're so hard to get that we just can't really route for it. In escaping from the grid node, some people bomb a place, and so the cops are going crazy, and we have to get away. And so instead of going through a crowd of enemies, as the game wants us to, we're actually taking a back route that the game tries to shoo you away from, but it's pretty fast, and you don't get shot as much.
Going around the left here is a couple seconds faster.
It's also a more interesting route, because you get to do some weird stuff like running on really narrow ledges. Yeah, I was a little worried jumping to that pipe, but it worked out. Let's not think about what would happen if I died in another place where you get reset to the beginning if you die. So we just unlocked fast travel, which is really handy. And now we get to watch a lot of cutscenes.
I actually sorting out. Watching without delay now, so I can help you with the commentary. Which would be good.
Now we're going to meet Dogen, the crime boss. He's going to give us some missions. He's one of the most entertaining characters to me. We don't get to see very much of him then. His name is very appropriate for this marathon. Yeah, getting to Dogen's place is normally kind of annoying, but we discovered that his place is right next to the place that Gridnode Run occurs. So you can use Gridnode Run to get there almost immediately. It's very convenient.
Dogen seems like a bad guy, but he's actually a pretty good guy.
Yeah, he's Dogen like is supposed month. To be, he's supposed to be a villain, but he basically spends the entire time helping you. I think you should humble me with a visit. Also, he works as a chef.
Far be it from me. Yeah. Does he work as a chef, or is that just like his hobby?
Oh, kind of his hobby. He opened a restaurant because he wanted to, but he apparently uses it for like nefarious activities.
Hmm.
You can bash that door before you get sucked into that animation, but I did not get to it fast enough. Now, we're coming up on Benefactor, which is the sixth mission, and it has one of the more interesting skips that we have. And it involves abusive quick turn glitch again, so that should be fun. It's one of the most precise quick turn glitches. So we use the map manipulation for that one. Basically, Faith, when you have the map open, Faith will always orient herself like beneath map to face whatever direction is north, and you can use that while quick turned to force Faith to face a specific direction while quick turned. And so when you jump or close the map and jump, Faith will jump in that direction, even if it's completely awkward to do, and it lets you jump in really precise directions.
The two what?
A giant counterweight intended to make the building safe for earthquakes and hurricanes.
And you can also do it without the map, but it's really, really hard. You can also do a springboard method to set up the quick turn glitch, but that method is really hard. Yeah.
Benefactor has some really good skips in it. Mostly including one of the later ones. But some of the minor ones on the way up to that are pretty good too. I can't really say about where you are now.
I'm currently climbing.
Thanks.
You know, the part where you the part with the mag swing and
okay.
Just before the back step trick. So here I'm going to run on a beam, and then I'm going to do a backstep, which lets you fly backwards if you're on a ledge. It's normally supposed to be like a dodge backwards, but you keep the speed if you fall off of a ledge while doing it, and so it's really silly. It doesn't have a lot of uses, but it's really cool. We found a lot of ways to get to the next room without going through this vent, but the thing you need to activate in the next room doesn't allow you to activate it unless you go through the vent, which is another unfortunate case of this game not liking speedrunners very much.
Yeah, it's pretty funny that they like took one of the best Mirror's Edge 1 speedrunners to help with development of this game, and then they just made it like anti-speedrun pretty much.
Yeah, you have to dig real hard to find good strats and good glitches.
Yes.
Alright, so for my version of the setup here, we climb on this plank that for some reason lets you climb on it. I didn't open the map fast enough. And I missed it.
Yeah, this flames
is,
up.
This is one of the trickiest things in the end, just because it's really awkward and precise.
Did you explain how climbing up the plank works?
You just
climb three times.
You jump and don't touch anything else, and the plank just lets you stand on it.
Doesn't seem to work if you have really low frame rate though, which is weird.
Oh, I keep failing it.
It's okay.
I don't want to have to do the old strat, because that's even slower.
Doesn't
All
really
right,
matter.
There we go.
Go overestimate anyway.
Yeah, so at the top of these pipes is a checkpoint that lets you end the level, kind of like in Savant. But it's at the top instead of the bottom. And that's the checkpoint. And so you're supposed to come here to destroy this building by going inside up here at the top and loosing a big, like, earthquake dampener to fall through the building. But since we skip that, it's basically just coming up to the top of the building and then leaving. That's pretty silly.
Just taking in the sights and then going.
And occasionally dying a whole bunch.
Yeah.
This is one of the most common places to suffer unfortunate deaths.
I think Savant and Benefactor are the two hardest missions in the game.
Yeah, especially since Savant got the faster skip.
Yeah. Without the corner wall climb, Savant is pretty easy, but...
Yeah, it's a pretty drastic change in difficulty, though. Glide glitch is pretty easy, even though I made it look dumb hard. And the corner wall climb is insanely precise, so it's pretty drastic. So now Icarus has gotten himself caught, and we have to go rescue him. So...
Get ready for a lot of that.
Yeah. Hopefully nothing will go wrong while we're rescuing him.
Hopefully.
And we can go back to our regular life of being a parkour delivery girl.
Icarus is very prone to being stuck. He starts off as like the, wow, I'm better than you and I need to tell you all the time. And then he turns into the, oh god, I'm stuck, please help. He's that type of character.
Let's all point and laugh.
Yeah, basically.
So, once I talk about little optimizations, doors sort of magnetize you to them when you try to bash them, and that is really fast if you do it from a distance, so it's always a good idea to bash doors from as far as possible. There's lots of little things you can do to optimize this game, and they add up a little bit, but that was a nice collision boost, but it's hard to identify them all. And the game seems to discourage a lot of it. It can be frustrating.
Icarus? No, I just talked to Icarus. I think he's nearby.
Right, we're gonna rescue Icarus.
He's alive. That's a relief. Thanks for the update.
So, we're gonna be at the top of a large, like, apartment block area. And the mission requires us to get to the bottom to free Icarus from this trap that he's got himself caught in. And normally that would be some platforming to avoid, you know, fatal falls, but we found that there's a line of air conditioners here, and if you just keep grabbing them and dropping onto the next one, you can just fall the whole way without really risking anything. It's very convenient. I think it's come to have the name Jackie Channing. I don't know about the Wolfenstein.
There. Done. You owe me one.
I do. Thanks. If you're looking for an easy way back up, maybe there's an elevator somewhere. I know this is nothing like it, but I sort of understand what prison must be like now.
Icarus, the game expects us to take a much longer time to get to this elevator. So Icarus's dialogue that he would normally be saying while we're going down is instead being said in this elevator. And it overlaps with the dialogue that's supposed to be in the elevator. You can skip this elevator, but it's extremely frustrating to do. Like, the hardest skips in this game are all doing really, really precise, like, jumps, and they're all extremely obnoxious. It appears this run is tilting our number one skip finder, Zenleaf. So yeah, the cops are raiding our runner headquarters. Apparently Icarus getting caught was like a distraction. Oh no, things went wrong. Now this time I'm not gonna let this van kill me. I don't want to get sent back. There we go. So this is the first really big fight that you can't skip, and it's interesting because it's pretty well optimized, but it's also still a mandatory fight, which is dumb. But you'll get to see the mechanics for fighting, which is mostly just jumping on people from height, but occasionally using wall run kicks and a very funny stun lock that I will use for the boss that we fight at the end. That guy off to fall through his death. They don't handle falls well.
Yeah. So that's one. Anything more than like 2 feet, and they die.
Yeah. All the enemies in this game fall apart when they come into contact with the environment. One of the annoying things about this fight is that the enemies come out in like a set time, and so if you're fast about beating them up, like, you have to wait anyways. So it's kind of like being punished for being fast. Almost. Now these guys are shock protectors. They were supposed to be introduced in the fifth mission, but we skipped their introduction. And they're very annoying because they use an attack that will basically like stagger you, and it makes it so you can't do the quick turn jump to kill people instantly because it messes with your aim, and they're just extremely annoying and too healthy, so nobody likes them. These gunners are really vulnerable to slide kicks for some reason. It's like their weakness. This is the last enemy, I think. So if I knock him into something to finish him, it should skip the finisher animation. There you go. So I think this should be the boss. We'll try to dispose of him in a funny way. But yeah, enemies don't know how to deal with you kicking them in the back. If you just keep kicking them, they basically can't do anything. That works on basically every enemy in the game. So yeah, that fight is kind of a run killer sometimes, because enemies can just refuse to cooperate. That fight went pretty well, but it really varies quite a lot.
Yeah, fighting in this game is pretty stupid. Although the enemies like don't really do anything differently.
It really is just their positioning, and especially the shock protectors, because their shocks, they literally just don't let you aim correctly. Even if you're aiming in the right direction, Faith just will not attack the right enemy, and so they're very annoying. And so now we bought Double Wall Run, which is one of the other broken skills in this game. It lets you perform two wall runs or two wall climbs in a chain of up to three wall actions. So you could do wall run, wall climb, wall run, wall climb, wall run, wall climb, etc. And we're gonna load and abort Flytrap, the mission we just did, to get... Or we won't abort it, but it gets us closer to the next mission very fast. Faster than we could get there by running, even in real time. So do you have like a real time stream now, Heki?
I do, but I can't mute it. Okay, now I have a real time stream.
Thank goodness. So yeah, now that our base has been raised by the cops, we have to go into hiding with the terrorist group that blew up the building after Gridnode, if you remember that. And I died, goddamn. But yeah, we're going into hiding because we're criminals and we're wanted.
Another loading screen.
Yeah. Thankfully, I'm not in the middle of a mission, so my checkpoint isn't really fixed. It just follows you around. Dying when you're not in a mission is really not an issue at all.
Not sure what point right now. Are we on the way to Sanctuary?
Yeah, we are on the way to Sanctuary. Heading there now.
Okay.
Now, I promised I would take a detour to show off a funny trick. And even though I have died so many times, I'm still going to show it off, because I promise, and it's a cool trick. And it uses my favorite trick, backstepping off of ledges.
Ah, I know what you're trying to do. I'd say that's worth doing. Sorry, I can't really say anything about this route, because I've never really seen it.
Alright, so this should be pretty good if I don't mess it up. So, backsteps are very fast, and landing pads will negate your fall damage no matter how far you fall, even if it's a fatal fall. And so you can do that crazy trick. And it doesn't save any time compared to the best route, but it is one of my favorite tricks in the game, just because of how crazy it is.
It does look pretty cool.
Now, there is a trick you can do in this room You are supposed to press a button to raise a dam and let you progress, and you can skip this button by doing a corner wall run. But as I've already stated, corner wall runs and wall climbs are extremely annoying. So wall running around a corner with like frame perfect precision. So I'm skipping that because it saves about like 5 seconds and I just don't think it's worth dying for.
It's probably a good thing to skip.
Although I did find that skip myself. So I'm pretty proud of that.
Glad they didn't add any like long waiting sections in this game.
There's one or two, like the crane sequence in Vive.
Yeah.
That one is really annoying.
And that makes two of you.
There's nothing quite like waiting on the planks at the end of Storm Drains. Yeah, now we're hiding out with the terrorist group, and we're gonna be taking orders from their leader for quite a while. Her name is Rebecca Thane, and she is very spirited and very communist.
Yeah, she's an ass.
She's another love it or hate it character. I personally like her.
I don't. She's really, really annoying. She just shouts all the time.
So here we're gonna start using the double wall run skill, which is very handy. Unless you get through these rooms very quickly.
Double warning is that it's not as hard as it looks.
It's really not. It's just straight up jumping at the next wall.
Yeah.
But it's really a powerful skill. Combined with quick turn, it basically means you can get like anywhere.
Yeah. As long as this game, you can just go.
What this game lacks in glitches, it makes up for. Well, slightly. It makes up for it slightly with just the sheer number of things you can actually do now compared to the original.
Chat has a request for you to do a 2929 roll.
You mean the one that like skips falling?
Yeah. The 2929 roll.
I think I already skipped the only one I know about.
Well, rip.
If I remember, if I think of one, I'll definitely do it.
I think there's one in Kingdom. Like after you do the thing to avoid the slide that you have to do. Yeah, I think you can just like drop down onto the bed that would have broken and roll off of that.
Oh, yeah, that would be pretty cool.
I guess you could try it, maybe.
Yeah, hopefully I won't die.
Maybe.
Alright, so we're coming up on Vive la Resistance, which is one of my favorite missions, because it's got really cool skips. It's also a good place to die, but hopefully we won't do that.
It's one of my favorites, too.
Yeah, it's one of the best missions, because it's got good movement, good skips. It's just an interesting level. Oh, I forgot. I have to pick up this upgrade, which is another sort of arbitrary key. It's not really useful in movement, but it's like, oh, now you can get through to this place. Almost forgot about it. Yeah, that is the last upgrade for Faith's glove. We've been getting a lot of upgrades for swinging and pulling, and now pulling of another type.
Nice try, Peter. I saw it. It's okay there. So climbing ladders is kinda... Do you have climb efficiency yet?
Yeah, I do.
So like, there's like a skill that makes you climb way faster, and if you don't have it, then it's painfully slow.
Yeah, ladders are always slow, even if you have climb efficiency, but at least they become bearable with climb efficiency.
Yeah.
You basically skip ladders until then.
Are you doing checks for skip?
Avoid the sentry drone's field of fire.
I have not learned how to do checks for skip.
It's fine.
Isn't it insanely
it's
hard?
It's kind of good for me because I don't know anything about it, so I can't explain it.
I'm pretty sure it's insanely hard.
Maybe. So you can skip that ladder by doing another double wall run, wall climb thing.
Now, there's a lot of useful double wall runs in this mission. They're all really, really cool.
They're just like everywhere and you throw them all together. Like doing a double wall run there is the only way you can speed vault that one.
So Icarus has gotten himself caught again. We rescued him from a turret. This mission is all about turning off of like gun turrets. To protect some people.
What was that?
But
you were like stuck in the stumbling animation, but you weren't moving, and then you zipped forward.
I think that was me activating the cutscene.
Hmm. That was weird. One building clear. Some terminals have several drones connected to them, disabling the next one. The red line is runner vision, which is there for like basically really new players. Like in the original game, they just had like red objects to guide you where to go. But in this game, they went all out with the handholding, so you can just follow the red line and it shows you exactly where to go. And it's kind of like on by default, so I think you would lose time if you wanted to turn it off in the speedrun. But I'm not sure. Unless it sticks when you go to new game.
I mean, we deviate from the red line quite a lot. This is the first skip. You can climb this thing if you jump at it like at the right angle, and it lets you skip a floor of running past turrets that will shoot you. Basically, there's two like Colosseum-style buildings full of turrets that want to kill you, and we skip going through them by doing a bunch of tricky little climbs. And that is a return glitch.
So just like Savant, this button is an override trigger, so everything else in the mission just auto-completes. And now you can advance to the end after skipping like, I'd say like five minutes of stuff.
You skip a ton of just running around, because it's supposed to be, it's just loops over and over, like gradually rising up towards the button, and with turrets shooting you the entire time. It's very annoying. We skip it all, thanks to all these out of bounds.
Most of the annoying parts in this game that are like really tedious got skips, so that's pretty good.
Yeah, we got lucky.
Also, Icarus is also a crane operator.
Yeah, he operates cranes and he gets caught. Those are his roles in the story.
So this doesn't look like Out of Bounds, but it's actually Out of Bounds. You're not supposed to be up here yet.
This is kind of a tricky skip.
But,
I'll just do the other side.
This game is very well designed, so you just sort of get out of bounds really easily by climbing up the wall. And now we're back in bounds.
Yeah.
Are you gonna try the collision boost?
I will give the collision boost a try. I have not been doing too well with collision boosts, but we'll see if I can get it.
You've got all the ones you went for so far.
Yeah, but I missed it. I went for it and I didn't get it. That one's pretty big too, isn't it?
Yeah. It's okay. They patched IL. No, never mind. No, you can still disable it. But you have to do it through the menu.
So we just helped the terrorist lady again, and now Next, Nomad is gonna want some help again. He's gonna want us to help, like, take back the runner base. And apparently we can do that, despite it being guarded. We could have done that any time, but we only do it when Nomad asks us to.
And before TP glitch.
Yeah, there's a glitch that lets you teleport to the thing you need to destroy in this mission. But we have no idea how to do it. We've been working for months to try to find it, and it just... we've never discovered it. Apparently, yep. One of the devs we talked to knows exactly how to do it, and constantly taunts us with it.
He, like, joined our Discord and just... he won't tell us how to do it.
We can't fast travel to the lair because it's been taken over, but... and so normally you're supposed to run here through, like, hordes of, like, enemies and turrets, but... release aborting still puts you in the lair, so you can just get here really quickly.
That's one time where the loading is actually faster than real time.
Yeah, that's a 2929 roll.
Hey, nice. Hope you're happy. So wall climbing and then kicking the enemies just does a shitload of damage, so I'm just going to be doing that over and over. Because it's the fastest way of killing people.
Skipped a finishing animation there. It's again knocking people into walls to finish them. There's no finishing animation for that, so you can save a little time.
Excuse me.
Yeah. We killed a few enemies, and now the base is ours, as soon as we leave. Who knew it would be that easy? All it takes to stop the cops is to demoralize them.
Just take away their tower, and then they're done. We even left one in there, he's probably just gonna run away.
Gotta leave a survivor to report back.
Oh man, I haven't done a pun yet.
If you haven't had any opportunities.
You're right. I'll slide one in when nobody expects it.
Oh, that's good. Sure. We'll all be guffawing.
So keep your eyes peeled for the pun.
So this time we have climb efficiency, so we don't need to do the quick turns to climb faster. It's just barely faster to just climb the ladder. So that's that mission taken care of. And that is the last upgrade point we should need to spend. And now we need to go talk to a prisoner the terrorist group has captured. This mysterious woman that they were capturing during Viva La Resistance. Her name is Isabel Kruger. I think she's the daughter of the head of the police force that have been pursuing us.
Gabriel Kruger's daughter.
Yes, Gabriel Kruger's daughter. Isabel Kruger. She's very mean.
Yeah.
You again. Disappointed? I don't care either way. You'll be dead soon.
No, that wasn't the pump.
Anything for his dutiful daughter, right?
It's just a joke that you can't see puns.
So now we're going to the last new district, which is The View, which is the wealthy district. It's very pretty. And also, it used to be a place where people died a lot because it's got some weird tricks that you do. But it's gotten better since. And we're going to break into the police headquarters to steal some information.
Is this the art museum?
I don't think it's an art museum. I think this is the reflection building. I don't know what it actually does.
It looks really cool.
It is a really cool looking building. We do actually go to an art museum later.
Oh yeah, we do.
Yeah.
It's pink. Is it pink? I feel like it's pink. Might be purple.
It's the museum, I think, is pink. But I'm not sure I would ever do a 100% run Vodian. I don't really like the idea of a 4-hour run for this game. I think 1.5 hours is enough for me.
Yeah. 100% is going to be like 6 hours, is it? 4 hours? Something ridiculous that nobody should ever do.
So there's one cool trick in the mission that we're coming up on, which I really like, but it's also really precise. So I'll give it like a handful of attempts and see if I get it, but I'll try not to linger on it too long.
Is it the drop?
Yeah, the door drop. One of my favorite skips, just really hard.
I think I only ever got it like once. It's like way harder than it looks.
Yeah, it looks stupidly easy and it's actually really, really hard.
Have you ever like had a run where the collision on that little tightrope didn't spawn?
I've had runs where I tried to jump onto it and it didn't let me, but I've never had it not let me just walk onto it. I've only had it fail me if I tried to like springboard. So, if that's what you're asking.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're chasing a helicopter or a VTOL. That was dumb of me. But yeah, we're chasing a helicopter to the base, and we're gonna ride the helicopter into the base. That'll be an adventure. And instead of following the red line, we do some shenanigans on our way there.
5 minutes? No. 1 hour? Yes.
Well, no, there is 2.5 minutes of holding W at one point.
Oh, yeah, you're right, actually. That's pretty good. Do you have a soul, Cassie?
No.
You heard it here first. That's what someone asked in chat, by the way. That wasn't me asking you if you have a soul.
Yeah, I saw.
Okay.
I was just debating whether I should answer and condemn myself. Yeah, I sold my soul to get good at the original Mirror's Edge.
The harder one.
Yeah, the harder one.
I like how you can just land on a table and nothing happens. Like a glass table and it doesn't even break.
Super glass. Glass of the future. You get a checkpoint going into this vent, and it's later, and if you reloaded the checkpoint, you would appear later in the level. But it's a short enough distance that it's not really worth the loading screen. At least not in RTA. Now this is the elevator shaft, and it's kinda... Oh, I forgot about that. But yeah, it's pretty interesting, because it's normally a slow descent, but we've made it pretty fast with a lot of optimizations, including the door drop, which is my favorite skip.
Door drop's pretty good.
So first we're gonna do a death abuse by walking onto this checkpoint down here, and that sets up the door drop. And basically, I'm gonna try to cancel a fatal fall by bashing a door at the bottom of the shaft.
Bottom of the shaft.
One thing I need to do before I do this. Ah, I'm dumb. Totally forgot I don't have coil. Ah, I forgot to buy coil. Alright, well, no door drop for me unless I... I'll give it one attempt here.
You can do it, smiley face.
Yeah. Alright. But basically, if I manage to hit that door, if I finish the animation for breaking down that door before I hit the ground, I would not die.
Yeah, you can, like, cancel your You'll stop falling down and you'll go forwards instead because you.
I have not done this with that coil in so long. So yeah, this is an MOA. So many silly deaths. This game tends to have a lot of.
How much does Dojo save?
I think like 15, 20 seconds. It's pretty good. Because the elevator takes a while. What next?
Nice 2929 roll. So now we're breaking into the dog.
These buildings are called the dogs for some reason. I guess because the police are dog themed or something. And that's another death abuse. We skip an elevator. It's in RTA, it's basically the same speed, but it's a time saving game time and basically break even in RTA. I miss coil.
Do you not get coil?
Yeah, I forgot to get coil because you'd have to talent differently with butt skip. So this room is a long descent and we skip most of it by jumping in really precise places. That ledge is just high enough that you won't die dropping onto it. So instead of doing a bunch of platforming and running around, you skip it all. One of the bigger, just basic skips. This is our server room, by the way, that we are stealing information from, and that's the entire reason we came here.
You can actually soft lock in this room if you clip through a little bit early, you'll get like sealed in for a while.
Yeah, that door, you can. The old way we did the butt skip was you would slide and then quick turn twice, and that clips you through things. And you can do that on that door, and it'll hit a trigger and soft lock you because the door won't want to open.
I wonder if you could butt clip and then backdash straight away to get out of there now.
That guy did not want me to get behind him.
So once again, just climbing the walls and dropping down onto the enemies because it does the most damage. Most of the time it's a one hit.
Now, once we finish off the last of those guys, a train starts timing. And there's a train sitting there, just waiting. And eventually, when the timer reaches zero, the train will come out and we can hop on it to finish the mission. But until then, we're going to play chicken with this guy.
He's another, he doesn't know what he wants.
He's another boss-style enemy. And you can fight him if you want, but you don't have to, because the timer starts around the time he spawns.
So these white screens that you see are actually FPS dependent. The more FPS you have, the less time it will take for the white screen to go away. So as a result, these are timed out after the runs when they get submitted to the leaderboards. Because FPS related things are silly.
So next we're going to visit Dogen again. And this game, I would say casually, it's probably better than the speedrun, just because it feels like it's more designed for casual players. It's you're faster in general, it's easier, you got more diversity of movement, so less glitches, more freedom, I guess, if you don't really like invest in the mechanics. I would say it's better casually. Especially with the open world. If you just want to waste time, it's a pretty good game. The speedrun is kind of taxing.
The speedrun is like fun for a while, but then when you do it like more than a few times.
It's fun while you're learning the strats, but then once you're actually good at the strats and you have to optimize the movement, it just stops being fun because the movement isn't very good.
I wonder why it's harder on PC than it is on console.
Catalyst?
No, the clip out of the room. in the server room.
Oh. I don't know. I wasn't aware it was harder.
Yeah. On console, you can like open it and then get out, but on PC, it closes like way too fast.
And now we're going to a super secret underground base to try to rescue our mentor, who was captured during the raid on our runner base. Yeah.
This mission is called Thy Kingdom Come.
Yeah. It's
the facility is called Kingdom.
Yeah, it's an interesting mission because it's one of the few missions we haven't found like any real skips for. Like we can't do anything out of bounds and we can't like break it. So it just really is like straightforward platforming.
It's like really easy to get out of bounds and on top of the level, but
yeah, you can get out of bounds
back inside
super easily. But like you can't hit any checkpoints, you just can't do anything. Like the checkpoints are all really rigid in this level. So if you miss any, you just can't finish the level. It's very annoying. Still, I think it's a pretty fun mission, just because you get to really exercise the silly mechanics that this game has. I think when this game really shines, when you actually get to like do platforming, well not precise platforming, but like doing climbing stuff with quick turn and double wall run, that part really feels good. That's when the game shines, I would say. And when you're doing crazy skips.
Did you do the 2929 roll?
I tried, but I got a slide.
Oh, okay. Maybe it's not possible. So now we just go deeper and deeper into the facility. Because... video game.
Yeah, there's bunches of laboratories with people doing unethical experiments. And we ignore them because we're not very nice people. Now we get to see some very competent guards.
Say competent. That's a bit of an understatement.
They're so good at catching you.
There's not really much to say about this area. You're sort of like running through, very linear.
Yeah, we found, like I said, or like Heki said, we found dozens of ways to get out of bounds and get in various places out of bounds on this level, but we haven't found like any way to hit triggers we need. So there's basically no way to skip anything on this level. And as such, it's one of the few missions that is almost entirely preserved in its like glitchless form.
Pretty much.
We just met a scientist who was in prison. And it was... she was like a really, really minor character earlier in the game that you don't even see. And so you're supposed to remember her, but you don't. Never really, because she's so minor. So now we're running and trying to find our mentor. And there's lots of guards who suck at chasing you. And I missed a little trick there. And I took near fatal damage.
It's basically in the flytrap mission, they're like, yeah, Noah's dead. And then you do something else, and they're like, nah, Noah's alive. And now you find Noah.
And now we're about to find Noah, but he's dead. So we're gonna leave now, because...
yeah. Noah is gone for real this time.
Yeah, dead Noah. No reason to be here.
Also, fun fact, the guns in this game don't have bullets. Everything is electric.
Yeah, you can't pick up the guns because apparently you don't have the right, like, genetic ID for it.
Is that why?
Apparently that's the in-universe justification. They're, like, bio-tagged to their owners. So,
oh, okay.
You couldn't use them because they wouldn't fire.
You're okay. Great. What about We go here because we're told that Noah's not dead and he's being held here.
Yeah, Noah dies as we get here, so it's supposed to be all tragic and stuff. But
yeah.
He's dead. It might have been more tragic if he'd had more time to be like a character.
So tragic.
Yeah, last group of very competent bards. Ugh.
Sorry, I keep yawning. I got up early to do this.
So it's a slightly awkward time for the both of us in terms of scheduling. And so now we're bringing back the news to Icarus, and he's very sad. For having a bonding moment between Icarus and Faith. But Icarus is still a terrible character.
What happened to you?
We were moving your sister topside when all hell broke loose.
And now we visit Dogen one more time.
It's the best cutscene in the game.
Oh yeah, the best cutscene in the game. It's the only cutscene that is actually like well written and interesting to watch. But
yeah,
sadly we skip all the cutscenes.
It's kind of weird how they gave the story writing, like they let one guy do it, and he's done like nothing else apart from two really awful games. So I don't know why they let him write the story.
I mean, at least you got one cutscene, right?
Yeah. It's pretty stupid.
I don't remember if my loading speed lets that one like epic line get in before the cutscene ends. But I hope it does.
Nothing to finish.
Celebrity visit.
You gonna break my leg now? Might as well get it over with.
You should finish what you started. Then I can have your legs broken, if you want.
There's nothing to finish! Noah!
Ah, cut it off at the very end. So now we're gonna do another mission abort to get to the view. Because we don't have any safe houses in the view to teleport to. So it's faster to mission abort here. Because we need to go to a museum at the far end of the view. That's another long run. It's even longer if you don't teleport.
Plastic, I'm at the waypoint.
Noah is.
Wait a second, and that's it.
Is?
There was already a VTOL patrol. We'll never find out because the cutscene ended.
Oh. Is it the broken line? I mean, if you want to watch that cutscene, it's like the only good one, and it's actually pretty good. You can easily find it by searching up the, is it Family Matters cutscene?
Yeah, Family Matters Dogen cutscene, I think. It's a pretty good cutscene. It's my favorite.
So, I don't know if it was explained already, but if you load up a mission, but then you run away from the mission area, it just cancels the mission and goes back to the default mission you should be doing.
We don't do this on release, because release, you can't leave the mission area for release, so we have to abort the mission, and that means it takes two loading screens, which is why it's so bad for RTA.
Yeah, looting release just puts you back at the hub, basically.
So many silly deaths.
It's okay.
It doesn't matter. It's just a very silly run. But luckily I respawned right there because it's still free roam.
Yeah, the way this works in free roam is like it generates your checkpoints based on, well, I'm not sure what it's based on, but you can just like set your own checkpoints if you stand in one place for like a few seconds.
Yeah, you get checkpoints periodically when you're in free roam, so it's a lot less punishing to die in free roam than it is to die in a mission where you have set checkpoints.
Pretty pretty much. Do we have Double Warren yet?
Yeah, we have Double Warren. We bought it ages ago.
Cool. So the museum.
Yeah, the museum is interesting. Apparently there's a new route here that I don't know about.
There is?
I don't know. Apparently people get are getting hacked.
No, I'm not under the payroll.
What is with my Warrens today? They're all dying so abruptly.
Also, nice pun. Still haven't done a pun yet.
Who pun? Did I pun?
No, someone in chat did.
Oh.
Said I'm not under the dice payroll. It's a pretty weak pun, but it's a pun. Just double checking.
I'm inside.
Oh.
Good. You need to work your way through the building to the top floor. From there, you should be able to access Kruger's lobby if the schematics are correct.
So now we're just gonna navigate through all the enemies, because you don't want to stop and kill
enemies. The enemies suck at catching you. And quick turn kind of breaks this mission, because you can just skip so many floors of fighting that you would otherwise have to go through. Although you can still run past the enemies.
Yeah.
Quick turn is silly. But yeah, you can skip a bunch of stuff in there. Normally you would have to run past enemies for much longer in that way.
Yep.
It's kind of silly how easy it is to run past enemies.
Also, I think this room is made to look like a chapter from the first game. I think it might be like a small Easter egg or something. This is actually another one of those near the beginning of the game. They have a room from Prologue.
Yeah, one of the rooms we skipped on our way to Birdman's place, way at the beginning of the game, is a reference to Prologue in the first game. Basically,
yep.
Like a mirrored version of that room.
Also, in this elevator, when he says, Plastic says there's another way, but I don't think there is another way.
Also, this elevator is weird because just as it starts to rise, there's an invisible object that passes through the middle, and I have no idea what it is. But if you try to stand in the middle, it'll push you away.
Huh. That's weird.
It's very weird. I have no idea what it is.
Yeah, it's impossible to escape Prologue.
This cutscene is weird, because sometimes it skips instantly, and sometimes it has to load something. And I'm never sure what triggers it to skip quickly.
But I think you just have to wait for the end of the dialogue.
I didn't get the quick skip, so...
Until she says we've got it, and then it should be done.
I don't know, I've never seen a consistent pattern, but maybe you...
You played this more than me.
I have, but I don't remember, like, anything. That's evidenced by all the silly deaths. Yeah, for some reason they call their, like, flash drives shotguns. I don't know why.
Also, the elevators in this game look like they're from Mass Effect.
And they climb like they're from Mass Effect. Alright, so we're about to do one of the most notorious missions called Tickets Please. It is a very dumb mission. Because it is hard, and if you die, you get reset really far.
It's the only thing in the game that has cycles, so you have to either wait for the cycles or beat them. And beating them is hard because the cycles are moving platforms, and the platforms aren't very well designed, so if you climb on one too fast, you slide off the side of it and there's nothing you can do. So basically it just forces you to go really slowly.
There are fast routes for it, but if you die on any of the platforms, on any of the sections, you go all the way back to the previous section. And
yeah,
that's like a minute or two of loss.
So they're not really RT viable, they're just more IL strats.
It's a very, very silly mission. Nobody likes it.
Nobody at all, ever. Except I think Zen likes it, but... That's a Zen.
Zen likes everything about Catalyst.
Good, you're there. Connect to the console I've marked for you, and I'll tunnel in. Once I start spraying the hubs, you'll have to be fast getting to each one.
So as you can see, you need to pull these down. This one's not on a cycle, but it's just introducing you that you have to pull out the platforms.
You actually don't have to pull out the platforms for that one. You can climb on them while they're in their while they're still cased, but like it's kind of hard. I haven't really learned how to do it consistently yet.
So a funny thing about this game is when the beta came out, we abused a thing called stumble boosting, where you could get a heavy landing on something and then you like slide off and you get another heavy landing and you get shot forward. But they wanted to patch that, so now you just get heavy landings anywhere if you fall off like more than one floor.
Heavy landing is going to be really frustrating.
Yeah. Kinda sucks.
This is the hub that can potentially screw me. Because the top...
Do you not despawn in the cards?
No, I don't really care about them. But the top platform is really, really glitchy. Oh, and I made a mistake. I hope I don't die.
You might die.
I might die. Yeah, I died. Okay, well. Dying on this level sucks. My life. My life.
You should despawn them.
Yeah, I should. You just pass the objects up the stairs and you back out, right?
Yeah, just run up till you see the guy and then just like backdash twice and you should go away. You can see by the circle on the screen.
Oh, this run has been a tragedy.
So the way despawning works is... I don't know why they did it, it's really stupid, but DICE put a range on enemies, so if you get too far away from them, they just disappear. Which in this level is pretty useful, because you can just spawn them, and then like they spawn when you're in the radius, and then you can just go howl the radius and continue the mission without them being there.
Alright, let's see if we can get this. Should have done it. I think so.
Yeah, that's good. So that's some 10 out of 10 programming.
Unfortunately, it means I miss this cycle.
Yeah, you could have started on the other wall there. So yeah, this mission is like the worst and everyone hates it.
Yeah, it's absolutely the worst.
It wouldn't be too bad if they actually like designed it right. But you just slide off of everything you tried to climb on, so it's just kind of bad.
Thankfully, the next mission is the last and is really, really easy, so...
Yeah.
That should wrap things up pretty cleanly. But yeah, this mission sucks. This last hub is really annoying too, because you have to wait twice for this thing. First you have to pull it down, and then it goes back up before you can climb onto it, and then you have to wait for it to come back down.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
It's really dumb. But at least you don't have to unlock the other one, because you can just climb directly to the pipe.
So that's all of the towers climbed, and now we head back to the hub, and all of the disease is gone.
We can finally purge this mission from our system.
Yeah. basically just running and running back to the lair.
Yeah, that's...
This game has a lot of just running and running.
That's kind of the weakness of this game. Just there's not a lot to do when running.
Unless
you have a wall to boost off of.
Even then, there's not really much.
Alright, that is that mission done. We can finally move on to the last mission.
Alright, this is... if you played the first game and you know the name of the final mission is The Shard, this one is also called The Shard.
Yes, but it's a bigger shard.
Yeah, the biggest shard.
Because it's the future.
It's also way better, haha.
But in the original game it's horrible. Alright, last fast travel. Second to last loading screen, I believe.
So if you remember, the first game ends with you on top of the building on a helipad. This game, when I was playing this casually, I thought it was going to end the exact same way.
They certainly set you up to think it.
It gets you up to the helipad, and then that's basically it. But then you go down, and you have to do like a big fight and stuff. And I won't spoil, but something pretty cool happens.
Yeah. This run ends in a pretty interesting way. For people who may not have seen it.
Yeah.
The shard is kind of interesting because it's largely unoptimized. There's not a lot you can do to save time in it. It's also pretty easy.
This is another one of those screens that's FPS dependent and is timed out after the run.
Yeah. It's pretty silly. This one is shorter than the one after the break-in mission though.
Yeah, you can't really pick this screen up for the script.
This is this area is an homage to the train sequence in the first game. But it's way worse and less interesting. Because there's nothing to do, and there's no penalty for getting hit by the objects.
You can actually just hang on the inside of both the trains. But do it on the left side, otherwise you'll get hit by the I guess, traffic light. The long one. And if you get hit while you're hanging, you just sort of fall.
Oh, that sounds
awful. Stay on the left side and you won't get hit.
Alright, last boring sequence. You're supposed to run along, like, breaking glass here and try to find safe spots, but these metal beams don't break at all, so you can just run straight up this run.
Yeah, that train ride was a flashback. Flashback? I don't know. What am I thinking?
Loading screen?
No, the word am I looking for?
Throwback?
I guess throwback.
Homage?
Homage, yeah, there we go. Homage to the first game, is chapter 4. Where you ride a train for 50 seconds.
It's the best part of the game.
And I think, again, they use the gimmick of the train doesn't move, but the walls move around you. Pretty sure that's how they did it in this game, too. So it's like an illusion of you moving, but you're actually not moving.
So there is actually one more use of cycles in this game, but this one is not as annoying. It's a fan. You need to ride up to another level, and the position of the fan blades is random, basically. And
yeah.
You can get lucky, or you can get unlucky. It can cost you as much as, like, I think 5 seconds.
Got pretty lucky this time.
Yeah, that was a pretty good fan second.
Also, I think anyone that played this game and did this section thought it was complete, like, bullshit.
Yeah, most of the shard is bullshit. Especially the really late parts.
In a game that they tried to focus so hard on, like, realism, that's just weird.
I wouldn't call Mirror's Edge Catalyst realistic.
Yeah, that was their aim though. Like they took the animations and stuff from like actual people doing parkour and stuff like that. And they tried to sell it as like realistic.
So there's debris falling in this room, and one of them normally blocks your path, makes you wait, but all the debris is scripted by like triggers that are layered over the poles, and so you can skip that one by doing a wall climb and then jumping through the pole to skip the trigger. That's nice.
So do you want to shout time or do you want me to do it?
You can.
Okay. It's coming up in about 5 minutes?
I would say like 4-ish, but around that. Yeah. So we're coming up on the cool ending of the shard.
Yeah, this is the atrium.
Yeah, it's...
I'm pretty sure it's the only place in the game that actually has like nature in it.
Yeah. It's a cool room, but we don't do anything in it, which is really disappointing.
Yeah, I wanted to like climb up the trees or something instead of just mag roping over.
Yeah, it's definitely the most disappointing room.
Yeah.
I saw it in like the previews and I was so hyped.
Without doing like the intended route for this mission is just mag roping everywhere, which kind of sucks. So this is the... probably the funniest skip in the game, I'd say. Where you confuse the game into thinking you're on the pole and the swing bar at the same time. And as a result, it just lets you climb infinitely because it doesn't know what's happening.
Yeah, it's called pipe hole because pipe and pole.
And yeah. So
it's a very, very silly glitch. This pipe has all sorts of weird properties that we don't really understand, but as it happens, this room, the only place where you can do pipe hole reliably, happens to be underneath the end of mission trigger. And so you can climb all the way to the mission trigger, or the end of the mission trigger, and end the mission from this point. The climb is really long though, so it's like 2 minutes.
Yeah, so now you just... I don't know what you would talk about here, but you just sort of hold it for a long time. I guess you can look down and show the city, wasn't it?
Let's talk about the contortions face feet are going through.
Yeah, the feet in this game are like really weird.
I can't even see the city. I think it's behind us.
Yeah, it is. My bad.
look at these clouds and this ocean. This clipped building. There's another tower to the shard, but we don't go into it at all because of pipe hole. We just skip it entirely.
Yeah. It's just a lot of like platforming and stuff like that. Well,
I mean, it's not even platforming. Like you literally just mag rope all over the place and it's all like scripted. So
yeah.
There's no freedom. Which is good because we skip it.
There's also like a fight with two sentinels in the same room, which is kind of annoying.
And a room where you have to wait on an elevator while being chased by like 25 guards.
Yep.
Who are surprisingly easy to beat up.
Yep. Okay, so getting ready on time now. It's in a few seconds. And the time ends when you bash the door. So, 3, 2, 1, time.
That's Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
1:54:20.
Yeah, a little over.
Too many minutes. That was lost at the beginning.
Here's a dramatic fight.
It's pronounced Pipole.
Oh, Pipole, yeah. That sounds right.
I think Kale calls it Pipole, like Kenobi, but...
Yeah, that's Mirror's Edge Catalyst. Thank you very much for watching.
And this is the ending cutscene where you fight your sister and she flies away. And the game ends with nothing happening.
And my sister. I have no sister.
Good timing. I mean, my stream I'm watching is not like completely in sync. I think it's like 2 seconds off.
With mom and dad, I cried for months.
But yeah, it's Mirror's Edge Catalyst.
Alright guys, well, thank you for the run, and if you have anything else you want to say before we move on to the next game, which is Family Feud, if anyone's wondering.
Just thanks for watching. Play Catalyst if you like it.
Alright. See you guys.
Thanks.
Yeah, she's in love with the concept, as if we're all just how she imagined, 'cause we're in love, I just don't know yet. But tell me how.